The Wild did give up a couple of shots on that one, but nothing too dangerous. And we're scoreless. A couple of shots in the game for Colorado. That's it so far.
Oh, boy.
There's a penalty coming up.
Man, oh, man. Wow. Spurgeon was taken in from behind on the boards, and that is the kind of hit that the National Hockey League continues to see despite handing out suspensions for that type of hit. It's hard to believe.
It's very frustrating, especially when you see a player like Spurgeon down on the ice. Why are they still doing it? Why are guys still pushing guys from behind into the boards?
Well, you know what? I think the reason why is because a lot of times players are expecting it, and when they do get hit that way, a lot of guys are able to withstand that. Now, this is just, that's not that bad. I mean, he leans on him, he bumps him, but I know at full speed it looks a lot different. But I'll tell you what, a lot of players are able to withstand that kind of pressure. But if you're a smaller player like a Pierre-Marc Bouchard or a Jared Spurgeon, you don't have as much beef to hold back off of that. And they are going to toss him from the game.
They have to. I mean, this is a dangerous play, and you've got a player that could be seriously injured. I hope not.
But whenever you catch a guy in the numbers like that, his balance, because of the top-heavy nature of that hit, it can really be difficult. And I know it looks a lot different in slow motion. Right here, it actually doesn't look that bad because he puts his hand on his back and then puts his shoulder into him. But at full speed, that looks a whole lot different. And because of the fact that he hit him as he was taking him into the boards, that's why he is going to get the five in the game. Take a listen to this full speed, and he'll give you the impression. And you know, we're talking about the fact that Shane O'Brien just got a penalty in this game and was the catching up to the minutes leader in Cody McLeod. Well, Cody McLeod retains that title there with that penalty that he took, and he's gone from the game. And Spurgeon, thank goodness, is at least on his hands and knees and trying to catch his breath here. But a very dangerous hit there. And
Jared Spurgeon leading the Wild defenseman in scoring this season with 2 goals, 13 assists, and came into this game on a two-game point streak. And then, unfortunately, I don't think it'll continue.
No, and this could be various injuries right here. We obviously won't know until later, but I mean, he was taken in pretty hard, and he kind of went into the dasher. But the way they're helping him off, it looks almost like a leg injury, and which is surprising given the fact that what hit the boards was his upper body. But maybe the contact with the leg as well is going to mean that he's likely, with the way he's being helped, not coming back into this hockey game.
The Wild did scratch two defensemen tonight, Clayton Stoner and Greg Zann, and both scratched tonight.
Yeah, and here's the kind of game where you say, boy, you wish you had seven defensemen.